So students, in this video I am going to explain you about food chain and types of food chains which are present in the ecosystem. So firstly let us discuss about the food chain and then later let us enter into the topic of types of food chains. Fine. So what is food chain actually? Food chains are interconnected and they show the relationship between organisms and their foods. So here the different organisms will feed upon different type of foods, right? So based on that concept the food chains will be constructed. Right, so each normally there will be tropical levels which are present in this food chain. So actually what are those tropical levels, I'm going to explain you later. So each of these tropical level will be interconnected, right? Each of the tropical level will be interconnected, and even the tropical levels will also contain subtropical levels. So all of these tropical levels will be interconnected to form a food chain, right? So this food chain is based upon the type of organism which will feed upon their food. Right, so here one of the most important thing which you people have to remember in the food chain is the food chain begins with food and it ends with feeder. It ends with feeder, the food in the sense which is producing the food to the consumer. So here the feeder will act as consumer, or else this feeder will act as a herbivore, right? So the feeder in the sense which will depend upon the food material, right? So the food in the sense which gives the food material, right? So here the food chain begins with the food and ends with the feeder. So I have said you right, tropical levels will be present in the food chain, right? So what are those tropical levels? There will be actually three tropical levels. They are producer, consumer and carnivore, and the other name of consumer is herbivores, right? So producer, consumer or herbivores and carnivore. So these are the three tropical levels which can be seen in this food chain. And coming to the subtropical levels, so the producer doesn't contain any subtropical levels, but consumer, which is also called as herbivores, will contain subtropical levels. So they are primary consumer or primary herbivore, secondary consumer or secondary herbivore, tertiary consumer or tertiary herbivore. So these are the subtropical levels which can be seen in the tropical level of only consumer. Coming to the carnivore, so this is third tropical level, right? And this also contains two subtropical levels, primary carnivore, secondary carnivore, right? So these are the tropical levels and subtropical levels which can be seen in the food chain. So the type of food chain which you are going to select depends upon the type of example which you are going to take in the particular type of ecosystem. So let us see by comparing with examples. So before going to that, let us see what is the thing which you can see here. So producer, consumer, consumer, consumer. So these are consumers only. So if you see here, this is primary consumer, secondary consumer and tertiary consumer. So these three are subtropical levels. These three are subtropical levels. So rather than this, you can also write like this: producers, consumer and carnivore. You can write only three, but I have mentioned here five because these are the subtropical levels which can be seen. In the same way here, the carnivore, I have written only one carnivore. Normally there will be primary carnivore and secondary carnivore, which I have mentioned over there. You can also write primary carnivore and secondary carnivore, right? And one more most important thing which you people have to remember is that it is not compulsory that the top carnivore should consume or should feed only upon the tertiary consumer. It can also feed upon the secondary consumer directly, right? Rather than this using tertiary consumer, it can feed directly upon the secondary consumer, or else this top carnivore can directly feed upon the primary consumer, or else this top carnivore directly feed upon the producer, right? So it is not compulsory that the top carnivore should consume only the tertiary consumer. It can also consume the producer, primary consumer or secondary consumer rather than the tertiary consumer. In the same way, this top carnivore can also consume this primary consumer rather than the secondary consumer or tertiary consumer. Let us take the examples for understanding it clearly. So I have taken here three examples. So coming to the first one, grass, grasshopper, frog, snake and hawk, which is producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer. This is a top carnivore, and this in the sense the top carnivore, in some other books it is written as climax carnivore. So both are same, don't get confused. The top carnivore or as the climax carnivore, both are same. So here what do you understand by this particular example? Here the hawk will feed upon the snake and the snake will feed upon the frog. I mean the hawk will eat snake will eat the frog, and frog will eat the grasshopper, and the grasshopper will eat the grass. In this way the food chain is designed. So this is a particular type of food chain which can be seen in the particular type of ecosystem. Coming to the second ecosystem which I wanted to take here is that grass, rabbit, Fox and Wolf. So firstly, I have written here four in the sense here the tertiary consumer, that's what I have written here four. So I have cancelled that four and I have written five, which is top carnivore. Why? Let us enough. So here the grass in the sense producer, rabbit in the sense primary consumer, fox in the sense secondary consumer, and wolf previously I have written 4, which is a tertiary consumer, but I have cancelled it and I have written 5, which is a top carnivore, because this is the last one, and the last one should be definitely carnivore, and the first one should be definitely producer. So this is one of the most important thing which you people have to remember. The food chain should not stop at consumer itself, it should stop at top carnivore. So you have to mention this wolf as carnivore. 5 in the sense top carnivore, right? So here what I have mentioned here, the fox is 3 and wolf is 5. So fox is nothing but the secondary consumer and wolf is top carnivore. So here the top carnivore directly consumed the secondary consumer rather than the tertiary consumer. It did not depend upon the tertiary consumer, it directly depend upon the secondary consumer. So that's what I have said you previously. So this is not compulsory that the top carnivore should feed only upon the tertiary consumer. It can also feed upon the secondary consumer or primary consumer or directly upon the producer. Fine. So this is second example which I have taken. Coming to the third example again, grass, goat and man. So grass is a producer and goat is a secondary consumer, sorry, primary consumer or else only consumer, and man is a top carnivore. So in this case you cannot see any subtropical levels because the grass is a producer, goat is a consumer and the man is a carnivore. So that's what initially I have said you, right? Only 3 tropical levels are present: producer, consumer, carnivore. And if you see in this third example, only producer, consumer and carnivore, only 3 are present. So there is no subtropical levels which can be seen. Fine. So these are the 3 examples which I wanted to show you by explaining this particular type of food chain. So now you have understood the concept of the food chain, right? So this is very, very important to remember. And here one of the most important statement I have given you here: food chains show that how the energy is passed from one organism to another organism. So if you've seen the examples which I have shown you here, so this grass will act as a food source, food energy source for grasshopper, and the grasshopper will act as a food energy source for the frog, and frog will act as a food energy source for the snake, and the snake will act as a food energy source for hawk, and the same will be repeated over here also. So if you see here, the food energy source is passing from one organism to another organism in the food chain. So this is one of the most important thing which you people have to remember. And this is just the introduction which I have given you about food chain. I hope you would understand it. And now let us discuss about types of food chains which are present over here. So coming to these types of food chains, there will be of 3 types: grazing food chain, parasitic food chain, detritus food chain. So how these 3 food chains are classified? They are classified based upon the producers, type of producers. We know that the producer concept should be same, it should start with producers. I have said you in the case of food chain itself, right? So the food chain should start from producer and it should end with carnivore. So that will be applied in each and every type of food chain. But the type of producer which is involving in every type of food chain will be different. So based on the differentiation, this classification of food chains will be done. So they are classified into 3 types. So let us discuss about the first one, which is called as grazing food chain. So this grazing food chain is shortly said to be as GFC. They are shortly said to be as GFC. And the other name which was given is predatory food chain. Predatory food chain. So I have said you right that producers will be each and every type of food chain should start with producer and ends with carnivore. So remember this point, very, very important. Each and every type of food chain will start with producers and ends with carnivores, right? Ends with carnivores. So this is one of the most important thing which you people have to remember. In the same way, in the case of this grazing food chain, it starts with producer, but the type of producer which is involving in each and every type of food chain is different. In the case of grazing food chain, the producers are green plants. So this is very important. The producers is green plant. So this grazing food chain, it starts with producers which are green plants. And now we are going to consider this producers as first tropical level. That's what I have explained to you, right? In the food chain, these producers are first tropical level. Coming to the second tropical level, they are herbivores. And third tropical level will be your climax carnivores. Climax carnivores are nothing but the top carnivores which I have said you. In some other books, it is written as climax carnivores. So the best example of this grazing food chain in the sense, grass, antelope and lion. Antelope is nothing but the best example, like if you take deer, and the deer will consume on this grass, where we all of us know that, but lion will consume on the deer, right? And here this grass will act as producer, which is a first tropical level, and the antelope, which is a deer, is said to be as consumer, which is also called as herbivore, right? It is a second tropical level, and the lion is a carnivore, which is a third tropical level, right? And that's it. The food chain will end up to here. No one has any dare to choose lion as its food material. Hence, the food chain will stop over here itself, right? Only three tropical levels are present. So, if you see here, the name gives you grazing food chain. Grazing in the sense, the animals which choose the food material as grass. So, if you see this grass are nothing but the green plants. So, here the antelope, which is a consumer, which is a deer, will choose its food material as grass. It feed upon the grass, which is a producer, right? And once the animal which chooses the grass as a producer, then that particular type of food chain is said to be as grazing food chain, which is also called as predatory food chain. Fine? So, this is about grazing food chain. So, now let us learn about second one, which is called as parasitic food chain. And this parasitic food chain is shortly said to be as PFC. And it is a part of grazing food chain. It begins with producer. Of course, every type of food chain begins with producers. That's what I have said to you. And it ends with carnivores. So, here it begins with producers. And here, in the case of this parasitic food chain, the food energy source will start from large organisms and will be passed to the small organisms. Right? So, if to understand this statement, let us take the example. So, if you see here, the tree will act as producer, and fruit eating birds will act as primary consumers. I mean, the tree contains fruits, right? And it will be consumed by some type of birds, right? And so, this will act as primary consumer, which is also called as primary herbivore. And coming to the next one, parasites, which is also called as, the classification of the parasites, like if you take examples of lice or bugs. These are secondary consumers, which is also called as secondary herbivore. And next tropical level is hyperparasites. So, the examples of hyperparasites are like if you take fleas. So, these are carnivores. So, if you see here, there is subtropical level division in the case of consumers. So, this is your primary consumer. This will be your secondary consumer. If you see in the case of first example, which I have said you, there will be no subtropical levels, right? There will be normal tropical levels only, rather than subtropical levels, only tropical levels will be present. So, this is producer is first tropical level, consumer is second tropical level, and carnivore is third tropical level. But if you see in this case of example, in the case of parasitic food chain, there will be four tropical levels. I mean, the subtropical level has been involved. So, this is a producer, which is a tropical level, and primary consumer and secondary consumer are the subtropical levels of the consumer. And then, the third tropical level is carnivore. Fine? So, here if you see, this is a large organism, right? This is a large organism. As I have said you, the energy source will start from the large organism to the small organism. And this producer will access tree, which is a large organism. If you see the tree, it is very large in size. Hence, it is considered as large organism. And fruit-eating birds, this is less in size when compared to that of tree, right? I mean, the size has been decreased. So, that's what you can understand here. The size has been decreased. And coming to the parasites, which is called as lice and bugs. So, these are very, very small when compared to that of birds. And here, hyperparasites, these are very, very small when compared to the lice and bugs, right? So, here the energy source has been decreasing from large organism to small organism, right? So, this is what you have to understand in the parasitic food chain. So, this concept is highly important. But if you see in the case of pyramid concept, I'm going to explain to you pyramid concept deeply in next other videos. But if you see in the case of pyramid over here, the pyramid will be inverted because the food energy is passing from large organism to small organism. If the energy is passing from small organism to large organism, then the pyramid will be normal in shape. I mean, triangle in shape, which is correct. Right? But if you see here, the large organism will, the food energy starts from large organism to small organism. So, here the food energy is inverted. I mean, the pyramid will be inverted in shape. So, the pyramid concept, to understand the pyramid concept, I will make next other video. So, don't get confused. So, in this video, I'm just explaining about the food chain, right? So, just understand the food chain. What is food chain? That's it. And now, coming to the third one. Third one is detritus food chain. And it is shortly said to be as DFC. So the name itself indicates you detritus. Detritus means dead organic matter. Dead organic matter, in the sense detritus. So the meaning of detritus is dead organic matter. So the dead organic matter, like examples, if you take bodies of dead organism, either it may be human dead body or animal dead body, or you can take any other dead bodies. So bodies of dead organism and fecus material, the waste excreted material from the particular organism, either it may be the fecus of human beings or either it may be the fecus of the animals. It doesn't matter. It comes under detritus only. I mean the dead organic matter only, right? So this will act as producers, right? Producers, because each and every type of food chain will start with producer, I have said you, and ends with carnivore. In the case of this detritus food chain, here the producer will act as detritus. I mean the dead organic matter, which I have took the examples over here. So here I'm going to take two examples. Like if you see, detritus is a producer. And next, this detritus will be consumed by the microscopic organisms or macroscopic organisms. And these microscopic organisms, examples like if you take bacteria or fungi, and macroscopic organisms, examples like if you take snails or nettworms, right? And if you take this dead organism and if you bury it in a soil, then after 3 months or 4 months, then if you remove the dead body, only skeleton will be present, where all the flesh will be eaten by bacteria, or else it will be eaten by the earthworms which are present inside the earth, right? I mean, these snails and bacteria or fungi will be feeded upon this fecus material, but earthworms will feed upon the dead organic matter which will be buried inside the soil. Fine. So these are subsoil species. These microscopic organisms and macroscopic organisms, these both are considered as subsoil species. Fine. And this will act as what? This detritus will act as food material, which is called as producers. So these microscopic organisms or macroscopic organisms will act as consumers. Fine. So this will act as consumers. And coming to the second one. So this will be the finite example for you, for me, which I have said you, the detritus will be the producers, right? So it starts with the producers, I have said you. So this detritus will act as food material for other tropical levels. So here, in this case of detritus, the example which I'm going to take here is a dead leaves of mangrove tree. Dead leaves. So this is also dead organic material only, right? This is also dead organic material only. What is detritus? Detritus in the sense dead organic matter. So here the dead leaves in the sense it is dead organic matter only. Right, and once this dead organic matter, I mean the dead leaves, will fall from the mangrove tree, and once it is fell into the water, then it will be consumed by the small organisms. Like examples, if you take larvae, crabs, normally these are the just examples which I am going to take about the small organisms, and you can also take copepods, etc. Fine, and now this will be consumed by the fishes, right? And the fishes will be eaten by the fish eating birds. And here, in the case of fish eating birds, you can also write human beings, where we feed upon the fishes, right? So normally here you can take the detritus as producers and small organisms as primary consumers, fishes as secondary consumers, and fish eating birds or as human beings as carnivores. Fine. So this is what one of the most important thing which you people have to remember. So these are the three types of food chains which are present in the present ecosystem. So I hope you would understand about the food chains, and the food chain contains tropical levels, and the tropical levels contains subtropical levels, and each and everything has been explained to you properly over here. And still, if you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can comment in the comment box. And if you like my explanation, just like this video. And for more videos, you can subscribe our channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.